Welcome to Farm Sim 22, and here today we're on Animal Creek. So we're just going to do a quick map review of the map, and probably start a series here on YouTube. So, first off, if you are new to the channel and you like what you see, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, or if you like to share it, by all means, share it away. So today here, this is what you get on the map when you start it. Right now I'm on new farmer mode, so we got crop, and let's have a look here at the full map. Everything's pretty much the same as Elm Creek, except for this wise, I think these are like, you can buy these fields, maybe? Yeah, so you can buy these, and it's just grass fields, that's all it is, so. But he's got it pretty expensive at $114,000 for that little one there. Pretty much everything else is all the same. All the factories are in the same spot, or spots, I should say. And your map, you start off with fields 48 and 50. So, 48, these two, let's get out of there. Here are these two on the original map. He's got as one. There's no house over here on this side. The house is over that side there. So this field here on the original map, there's two of them. This one has got as, they're all connected as one. As you can see here. And then there's the house there on this end. You do get, excuse me, all the tractors. You get this guy instead of a pick-me-up. You get the bunker silos with this tractor and cultivator. This shed. You get sheep all around the fence. Sheep, or is it one of these pigs? Sorry. And then sheep, and this animal shed, vehicle shed, and cedar. There's the sheep's. He's got no manure heaps on here, but that's easy enough to put in. Horse pen, cow pen. Set up there. Here's the lotted cattle pen. So you put your goodies into here. And then we'll set up the auto feeder. And then you put in your mineral feed over here. And there you go. Chickens here. All these pens, I believe, are. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get into them. No, yeah, so it's chicken coop, cow pen feeding robot, large sheep, large pigsty, large horse. I guess we have to go in here, and then we can have a look. What you get here, so animals. Oops. So as far as the chicken coop goes, I believe it's 109,001. No, sorry, that's a double XL. So this is on here. This I think is more. So you get 360 chickens in one coop, and then we've got up the sheep. The large one there. Yeah, so it's that one for 65. And then your pigs. That's usually the most that's quicker. I think it's this one. Yeah, it's 170 pigs, horses. This one, large, 14 horses, and cows. Oh, a fruit crop. So, I believe it's this one. This one here for 160 cows, so doubles up here. The regular one you get for the regular base game. So that's alright. I never actually looked at that before, so yeah. So then let's look around over here to the back side. This is your tipper. It's not a good tipper for here with the animal pens because it lifts up on the 90, so it catches up on all the buildings. So the one I usually get, one I usually get is this one here, the Flegel, because it, as you can see here, it just lifts up on the back end, and it is a bottom push, so it works pretty darn good for the animal pen. And here's Hayloft. I don't know if you really need it on this map because your green silo over there will hold everything, so all fruits, all straws, hays, everything like that. So it's really no sense to have this guy here. And then this shed, I usually just get rid of it. And then I put in greenhouses. I get rid of this here. I put in greenhouses in here. And over here. And then I don't use these multiple silos either. I don't like the wooden ones. So I will get rid of these. And if you're just starting out and you don't, you know, you get $100,000, you actually make quite a bit when you sell them. So I'll actually show you what I, how I start the game. So I'll keep this shed here. Here and then go into here, just click on these buildings and sell them. If you want, you don't have to, but like I said, there's no sense in me keeping them. And then so here now we got 257,000 to start with. So I come over here and I'll plop a greenhouse. So production and greenhouses. I always take a large one here. So spin around, look. Turn it this way if you want. Well, I have a hard time getting them straight, so. You like how you got your ground level. So then I have one of these for each. That one's usually tomatoes, this one is lettuce, and this one's strawberries. This is how I like to have my map set up. And then I know your number 8 is close enough to our pens, your pig pen and your cow pen will actually use both the same one, but in this instance, I'm not going to do that. Set it up anyways here, so I got the mod I think on here for the for the small silent sensors. Maybe I don't, but anyways, nonetheless, this is the one you want. I believe, yep, where he could extend to. This right here, because it won't turn, I find, and so I can't place this one here because it collides with myself. So set it up over here. So you set this one up, you can put it right here because you gotta be able to have access to your sheep as well as your horses. And on the PC I do run horses because I got the horse mod. The happy horse mod. So yeah, you don't have to do nothing with the horses. So then there's that, and then over here I'll go to productions, and use the lime one, and then I'll just set it up like so, boom, and then I'm going to go to, I think it's going to get really the fire hydrants. I'm not sure. I don't even think I got them downloaded. So, with that, we won't worry about it. It's the fire hydrants free water, so it is most definitely worth using. And then, see, now I still got $2,000. So I'll come up over here. And I do use to buy anything saddle, so it's perfect for making or using it for feed for your animals. Saddle extension. Tools. So right here. The reason why I buy that is it's cheap, so do a little something here. So if you're hurting for money and you got climb machine pressure, line pressure, the rock pressure, whatever, for the line. And you're doing some role playing or whatever to dig your stones from here. You can get stones from here. Just go over here and you can drop the rocks, or you can, if you're role playing, you can take the rocks and move them over somewhere. Well, I didn't see what the price was, but drop it on the load and you will check that out. I don't normally do this because I have more than enough money right now. 158,000. And yes, I'm on easy economy here. A little bit laggy. Then after this, we'll carry on with the rest of the, not really the map, but the rest of the farm. Fields have been changed to $843. That's going to cost, me for this one trailer. So, $1,700 for two loads. Selling. So you sit here and watch it. So we got lots of stones, 44,000 liters of stones. So we have more than enough lime in there. Because for each, for every 1,000 liters of stone, you get 4,000 liters of lime. And let's have a look at the price of lime. So when you're selling off your lime, 4,000 bucks a liter. I don't think it's per liter, I think it's per 4,000 is what it is. Maybe a liter. I've never figured it out. So, so then it sells on top of the hours like all your other factories do. So we'll just hang out here. Speed it up. Speed up time here. Sold 50,000 liters of lime. I forgot to look and see what we had for money. It was $130,000, roughly. Under here, under our finances, and let's see. So buildings, yeah, $30,000 on products. That's not too bad for that, right? So you can do that if you want. I don't really do that. If I need the money, I put out it. So that's that. As you can see, some of these fields have changed, and some haven't. got them more squared up than what they were on the But yeah, so that's pretty much the only changes for the whole map, other than the rest of it's pretty basically the same. So yeah, for that, that's about it, I think, for now. I don't have anything else for this, to show for this. I got my weight when I come left here. So, I think at that, I'm just going to leave it at that. Maybe I can't lift the weight. So we'll leave it there at that, and thanks for watching, and I'm going to do a series, so keep your eye out when videos come out. Hopefully you like the map and you want to see some more of it. Leave comments if you want to know where it's at, and I'll leave a link in the description. And if you want to see the map played live, I currently have a Let's Play going on Twitch, where I usually stream once or twice a week on Fridays and Saturdays. So yeah, it's Zoltan Games 1 on twitch.tv. So yeah, if you want to check it out live, that's where it'll be. Otherwise, I'll do some recorded videos and try and get some pre-recorded videos going so I can have some content almost every day, if not every day, or a couple of days. I'm not sure how it's going to work out yet with my job, so yeah, until then, thanks for watching, and happy farming.